What's up and welcome back to my channel. Now today I'm going to be giving a review for the film Resident Evil Vendetta. Now this is the third CG animated film based on the Resident Evil video game series, which is my favorite gaming series, by the way, you know. Because you know they have Resident Evil Degeneration, then they have Resident Evil Damnation. So this is the third one. Now I thought the Degeneration was like pretty cool, like pretty good, you know. My also thought Damnation was actually much better. A much better like Resident Evil like CG film, you know. I thought that was much better, you know. And this one turns out that this one is pretty good too as well. I still don't think it's as good as Damnation was, but it still turns out to be a pretty decent Resident Evil film in the end, you know. But another thing, like I say, this is about the now this is still based on like the gaming series, like the previous two films, you know. But the thing that's cool about it, you have Leon, he returns because he was in the first two, you know, Degeneration and Damnation. He returns again, but this time you have Chris Redfield joining the film too as well, which is cool, you know. Then you have Rebecca Chambers too as well, and these are actually like characters from the game series, you know. So I think it's kind of cool that you have like Chris and Leon and Rebecca as well, all like teaming up together to take out like a new threat, you know, which is like a madman who lost his wife, you know, while he was getting married. Yeah, the villain of the story, his name is known, I think it's Arius, if I'm not mistaken. And he lost his wife, like, in the, when he was getting married. And actually, his whole name is Glenn Arius, and he's, like, a death merchant. And while he was at his wedding getting married to, like, his supposed wife, he was, like, bombed, you know, they dropped a bomb on him. So because of that incident that happened to him, he wants to seek, like, revenge on, like, you know. I guess that's why his character was kind of off, you know. It's kind of confusing what's going on with him, but he wants to actually seek revenge, you know, against, I guess you could say, humanity in general, you know, because he wants to release, like, a deadly virus that would infect everybody and turn everybody into zombies and stuff, you know. So that's what he's after, and he wants to do this, well, he starts to do it in New York, you know, but I think he wants to actually eventually spread. So you have Chris and Leon and Rebecca who must team up to take him out and stop him, you know. And it's also like a... it's not really a connection, but it's something like with Rebecca Chambers, you know, and Arius too as well, you know. But I'm not going to touch on what it was, you know. But overall, I thought this was a pretty entertaining film, you know. And it's cool, like the main big plus of the film is seeing, like, you know, Chris and Leon together, you know, like fighting zombies and all that stuff. Because they actually teamed up for a little while in Part 6, Resident Evil Part 6, the video game, you know. But this time they actually had like a much more closer like relationship in this film. You know, they're more together. Even with Rebecca, you know, they have to decide what they're doing and everything. They have a lot of screen time together, which I think is awesome, you know. Now this is Chris Redfield's like first debut in the CG animated film. So he have like a new actor playing him, like providing his voice, but I'm not gonna touch on who that is. Plus this is also Rebecca Chambers' debut, you know, in the actual CG animated movies too as well. Now Leon, like himself, you know, he has Malcolm, I think that was his name, yeah, Malcolm, yeah, Matthew Mercer. He returns to provide the voice of Leon. He provided the voice of Leon in Resident Evil Damnation. So he does return to provide his voice, you know. Now like I said, now the director of this film is I know it's like an Asian name, I think it's Takanari Tsuchimoto, I think that's how you pronounce it. I'm sorry if it's not, you know. He has like a kind of a complicated name. It's like Asian, you know. He's the director of this film, you know. But overall, like I said, I thought this was like a pretty good film, you know. It kind of like drags at the time. Not really drags, but it's like it is kind of like holes in it, you know, to like a certain extent. But I thought that it was cool. It was cool that they brought Rebecca Chambers back because she's been missing for like a long time. Well, she wasn't really missing, but her last appearance was in Resident Evil Zero. And that's been like a long time ago, you know. So I was always curious. And myself, I was always curious about what happened to her. You know, like, where's Rebecca, you know? What happened to her, you know? And it's cool that they had brought her back. And she's actually now a professor, too, as well. You know, like this, like, some kind of like place, you know. I forgot what it was, you know, but she's like a professor, you know. And I also like the idea that this film actually introduces the idea that the virus, you know, that kind of makes people like zombies and so on, you know, it's actually in everybody. You know, they already have it in them, but they actually have to activate it to make them turn into a zombie and so on. So I thought that was kind of cool because Rebecca herself, she had a scene where she was explaining it to like Chris and Leon, you know, that like the virus is actually already in them, even them, you know, as well, like already in them, but it has to be activated by some kind of like source, you know, to make them like zombies. So I thought that was kind of cool, the interesting concept that they're bringing into like the series, you know. Another thing too, I thought was kind of odd, they didn't mention like Jill Valentine or anything like that, or Claire Redfield, they didn't get no mention at all. So I'm kind of curious about what happened to them, you know. Plus another thing too as well, you know, this film is actually, It takes place between the actual game, Resident Evil 6, and Resident Evil 7. So it takes place between both of those games too as well. Now, not to not like the Mila Jovovich like live action films, you know, but I definitely really prefer these like Resident Evil CG animated films way more than I prefer like the Mila Jovovich films, you know, because they're more closer to the game. They're actually based in the actual like video game world, you know. So I think that's cool and awesome, you know, as well, you know. But then I thought it had lots of like cool action scenes, especially for, like Leon, you know, even like Chris, you know, but I thought Leon's own was kind of more like more exciting than Chris own. But Chris, they have some real cool exciting sequences too as well. Plus the film is like very like gory, you know, like blood, like you know, like the other ones they had, even like the video games, they're very like gory and violent, you know. So you have to be, you know, you have to be willing to accept that level, you know, of violence basically. But overall, I'm giving this Resident Evil Vendetta, I'm giving this a B minus, and I'm definitely looking forward to seeing like more of these, you know, if they make more of these. And I actually got to saw this in the theaters too. They had like a one day, one night screening event, which is June 19th, and I actually got to saw it. Yeah, actually this day, you know, when I actually got to saw it, you know, in theaters, so I went and saw it, you know. And I know it's coming to video too as well, you know. But yeah, and I'm giving this a B minus, and I would definitely recommend this for like fans for like the Resident Evil like video games, you know. Or yeah, basically like the video game series. If you're a fan of like the video games, if you've seen the first two CG animated films, you know, I would definitely recommend it for that crowd. Alright, I know, yo, please subscribe to my channel, leave a comment too as well. Alright.